Hi, this is Dr. Subhatra. In this session, I am going to discuss about the visual aids and airport marking. So, landmarks will be usually provide to help the pilots for careful and safe landing during the bad weather and also in the good weather, both in the daytime and in the night time. Runways of the conventional airport appears as a long and a narrow strip with a straight sides. So the what places we have to provide this visual aids means at the edges of the runway, in the horizons, threshold of the runway, central line of the runway. These are the main places which a pilot should be able to view. So to enhance all these, we are marking these runways, taxiways, apron, everything by means of paints using some colors, or we can use some lights. Why this has been provided? Because to avoid accidents, to convey the pilot about the ground information, and to locate a particular place, that is whether it is a threshold line or the edge line, only then the pilot will be able to understand that, to provide safety to both the persons and also to the property, and to maintain the orderly flow of traffic and a safe landing and takeoff. What are the types of visual aids? One is by means of marking, by means of paints. Then the next one is by means of lighting. The bright lights are provided so that the pilots will be able to understand the positioning of the runway at a greater height. Then the next one is signage. Just like our roads, we can provide the signboards also. So these are the three ways of providing visual aids. So coming to airport marking. Markings are provided in all the components of the airport by means of strips, or by means of patches, or by solid lines, or by hollow line, or by using cart lines. By any means, we can provide the marking. The arrangements may be either straight or inclined or perpendicular to the runway. In airport, in which place you have to go for this marking means apron, runway, shoulders, taxiway, wind direction indicator, landing indicator. This is the picture shows the example of the markings. So this is the runway. The number has been marked, to which the number in the runway represents the in which direction the pilot has to orient their compass. This is the center line marking, threshold line marking, edge line marking, and this yellow colors are marked for the taxiways because the fuel spillage will be there. In which direction the curvature has to be followed, the end line is also there. This stop bar, beyond this there should be no movement at all, and the center line, edge line is shown here. Hold marks for landing and for the shorter operations. Beyond this, the aircraft should not come unless it gets the signal to travel in the runway. So these are the various markings provided in the airport. Then coming to the apron, it helps the pilot in maneuvering the most critical aircraft. Here it is marked in yellow color because the fuel spillage will be there. To resist that, we are providing it in the yellow color. It should resist the fuel spillage. Then apron markings, how the aircraft have to take a turn, at which location it has to stop, where loading and unloading has to take place, everything will be marked. This is a space in the apron. See, the curvature is given. In this way, the aircraft has to turn, and the nose of the aircraft is at the stop position. Beyond this, it should not move. So everything, all the directions and the curvatures will be provided in the apron region. This is how the aircrafts are parked in the apron positions. Then coming to the direction indicator, an arrow T is placed at the center of the segmented circle. See here, this is a segmented circle. An arrow or a T shaped will be provided. This indicates how the wind is happening and in which direction, whether in the crosswind direction or downwind direction or headwind, in which direction, whether the wind is supporting or not. It is painted in orange or white color. It is lighted during the night time so that it is able, we'll be able to easily see that. Especially it will help the pilots. And this is the segmented circle, and at the center the wind direction indicator is there. The direction from which the wind blows is indicated by means of a wind cone. See here, this is the wind cone. And it is placed inside the segmented circle, and it should be free from the obstructions from the buildings, and eddies should not be there. The panels are painted by means of white color. The wind direction indicator length should not be less than 3.6 meter, and diameter should not be lesser than 90 centimeter. Height, we should be able to visualize it at a height of 30 centimeter. In different bands, we can paint that indicator either by white and black, or red and white, or orange and white. So these are the wind directions. This is a T-shaped, tetrahedron shaped, and a cone is provided. This is the pictorial representation. So this direction, this tetrahedron represents the landing direction indicator, and this TL shaped at the outside of the segmented circle is a traffic pattern indicator, and this cone shape, a clock will fly based upon the as like our flag, national flag. It represents the wind direction. So all these contents I have taken from the slide share. Thank you.